This is YouTube Jeff's with WM King vs. Sandbox 2 Permian Apocalypse. Maybe we'll get actually Fire Planet. Maybe we'll get in. Yes, alright, let's begin. Sorry I had to stop part 1 early, but the device I was recording with did not allow my iPad it going anymore. So hopefully it doesn't happen again. Let's hope not. So after initial eruptions spew lava, ash, pumice, acid rain, gases, and on the first few weeks, as well as a volcanic winter. Temperatures plummeted. Temperatures froze. And then once the ice did finally melt, it got really hot. When the ice finally melted, temperatures skyrocketed. To change the mid latitude to red. This is what happens at the end of the Permian. Tons of greenhouse gas cause global warming to go mad. Come on, Meltos. Seriously. Seriously, it won't melt. But anyway, that wasn't all. Now, after a few years, the extinction. I really do not think the temperatures plummeted. They probably went up. This is what the earth looked like. Except for the ice, it was liquid water. And the next phase of the disaster is the reason why I'm erasing the water. So I want to do something that can't be done with to the actual water. We're gonna have to the oceans turn purplish pink. This is the oceans at the end of the Permian. They're filled with hydrogen sulfide from toxic bacteria taken over from plankton. This is it starts like 50,000 years after the beginning of the extinction. And this continues. Well, it kind of looks beautiful this way. These are the days when our living earth nearly died. Oh, by the way, on our calendar, this would be like December 21st. Thank you. asteroids breathe. This is basically your solution at the Emperor Stepford out there. And it was much warmer. And finally, a final way of extinction hits on land. Final extinction, the last extinction on land, wave of extinction on land. The land turns parched, barren. Finally, by this time, by this time, 95%, by the end of the extinction event, 95% of all life on land and sea combined, 95% of every living thing alive at the time died. And the 5%, the 5% lived. That 5% was the organisms that was the ancestors of the everything to fall. Everything that would be around to follow. Every creature, organism to follow, including the ones alive today. Eventually, the temperatures but that wasn't all. Finally, next came a global a drought, prolonged a drought. And this is basically, first came like 500,000 years after the extinction began. There was a drought that lasted another 500,000 years to a million years after the extinction. Then came global warming 250 million years ago. Then 248 million years ago is when the global warming stopped and temperatures rebounded. Wait, I forgot. There's one problem. I know why it's not showing the water. So I forgot to place the atmosphere pressure on it. And now, but at the beginning of the Triassic, this is like this December 22nd, like December 22nd at 5 p.m. is when the disaster began, but December 23rd, December 22nd at 11 p.m. is when it ended. And then begins the long road of recovery. First grass begins to grow back. After the disaster, after the apocalypse. the lush rainforests of the Permian are gone, replaced by deserts in the early Triassic. Refreshing streams gone, replaced by channels, empty channels, as well as Gorgonopsid, Listosaurus, on land, Gorgonopsid, Dicynodon, I mean, not Listosaurus, Saurus survived, Gorgonopsid, Dicynodon, Scutosaurus, and many others on land died. The sea, most of the fish, plankton, and sharks died, and all of the spiny sharks, all of the spiny sharks and trilobites died off, as well as most of the ammonites, etc. Life hanged by a thread, but eventually, millions of years later, by December 22nd, like, 3 in the afternoon, 24 hours later on our cosmic calendar, Earth recovered. Like, 20 million years later, or about 20 million years later. Thank you. And next time we'll talk about the extinction event that killed the dinosaurs. Thank you for watching. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe. As always, bye-bye. Bow, chicka, wah, wah.